Number 10. Decapitated gladiators. There are things found by archaeologists like skulls and skeletons or mummies and treasures. But some things they discover paint a much darker picture of people's past lives and deaths. Archaeologists discovered a group of skeletons in York, England. This group of skeletons belonged to large men who all died before they turned 45. What makes this find so horrific is that all the men were decapitated. Whoever buried them also placed their heads with them, sometimes between their legs or feet, and sometimes on their chests. Researchers don't know why so many of the skeletons found at the Driffield Terrace site had been decapitated. The remains are from between the 2nd and 4th centuries AD when the Roman Empire controlled this area. Because many of the skeletons were so tall and had signs of injuries, researchers think they might be the bones of gladiators. They may also have been Roman soldiers. Researchers also conducted genetic testing on 7 of the decapitated skeletons. They found that 6 of them came from Britain and only 1 possibly came from Syria or Lebanon. Why do you think they were decapitated? Number 9. Chernobyl. The Chernobyl disaster of 1986 was one of the darkest times in Ukrainian history. A nuclear reactor blew up following a combination of elements which led to an utter catastrophe. People were evacuated and they never returned. They were the lucky ones who survived, though no one came out of this scary situation well. An exclusion zone covering an incredible 260,000 miles was established, and inside that zone is a radioactive vehicle graveyard. Situated close to the village of Rosoka, this dumping ground represents the massive Chernobyl rescue effort. Various types of vehicles, from trucks to fire engines to helicopters, are on display, though we don't recommend you go visit. This place may be on the outskirts of the zone, but believe us, the danger level is high. And this nearly 4 decades on from the disaster. Unbelievable, right? Some sources state that what's known as the micro R level reads at between 20,000 and 60,000 hourly. It's a little complex to go into here, but micro R relates to red blood cells, or RBCs, picking up abnormalities in the bloodstream. The vehicles would have been involved in activities such as clearing up debris. There was also the small matter of building the steel sarcophagus needed to seal off the reactor's remains. How come the vehicles were just abandoned here? Aside from them being radioactive, it seemed to be the only practical thing to do. Authorities initially wanted to bury them all underground, but the plan didn't work out, so this seemed to be the best solution. Number 8. Hobbit Bone Cave. When you think of hobbits, you no doubt imagine cozy hobbit holes, mugs of tea, and the occasional dragon burning up the place. This kind of hobbit is very different. Hobbits don't exist, of course, but some people have often compared modern human beings to them. Researchers found the remains of Homo floresiensis in a scary cave called Liang Bua on the island of Flores, Indonesia in 2003. This Latin name translates as Flores man or human. Because examples such as the LB1 skeleton, thought to be female, have a small stature and large feet, they got experts thinking in a Middle Earth type way. Besides, this species has a low cranium, hunched up shoulders, and a broad pelvic region. When did they live? It's thought they were on the island between 190,000 and 50,000 years ago, relatively youthful in archaeological terms. These dates come from an analysis of details like tools rather than the remains themselves that only go back 100,000 years. This group is humanoid, but are they a whole other variety of humans like Neanderthals? The scientific jury appears to be out. Naysayers point to the tools found with these so-called hobbits, stating that the size of their brains meant they couldn't have made such items. Also, could the differences in appearance be because of disabilities? That debate goes on. In the meantime, experts tried to build a picture with what eerie evidence they had. They don't know for sure why Homo floresiensis aren't around anymore. Did we Homo sapiens push them out of the circle of life? Guess we'll just have to keep digging. Number 7. Monster Bird Claw. This may look like an old prop from Jurassic Park, but it's part of a living creature that took to the skies over 3,000 years ago. Now that's what we call scary. Even freakier is ancient tissue, which is still attached to the formidable claw. So what is this thing? It's the remains of a moa, a species that lived in the New Zealand area. While the specimen might be thousands of years old, the bird went extinct approximately 800 years ago. The claw was discovered in a cave on Mount Owen, part of New Zealand's South Island, in 1987. Reassuring, perhaps, not all moa birds were monsters like this. The largest ones reached a heart-stopping 12 feet in length. Yet the smaller ones were only about the size of a Christmas turkey, according to reports. The detail on the claw is truly out of this world. No wonder Star Wars actor Mark Hamill tweeted about the talon in 2021, comparing it to his old foe, the Rancor. Number 6. Skeleton Puzzle. An ancient skeleton is the remains of one person, right? That's not always the case, especially if this early find from 2001 is anything to go by. Put your jackets on, because we're headed for the chilly climate of Britain's Outer Hebrides. On an island called South Uist, there's a Bronze Age village called Clad Halan, which translates as cemetery find. And these aren't just any old mummies, but approximately 3,500-year-old bog mummies. Doesn't sound very glamorous, and to be honest, it isn't. But what is fascinating about these two examples is the journey they went through before finally being buried beneath a Bronze Age roadhouse. The man and woman, at least it's presumed that's what they were, passed away before being submerged in peat for preservation. They stayed there for about 12 months. After this, they appear to have been placed in a crouching position and then wrapped up. What comes next? The burial? Oh no. The evidence shows that they weren't laid to rest for hundreds of years. That's pretty scary, right? Experts believe the mummies would have become part of the community and spoken to in a reverent tone. We're not saying that's normal, just that back then, bodies weren't simply stuck in the ground and largely forgotten about. It was probably a standard routine for people to speak to mummies. Eventually, the mummies were buried. What prompted this isn't clear. The juicy part concerns who the bones belong to. Both had certain bones swapped over, making the mummies a weird and scary jigsaw puzzle of sorts. With the Bronze Age man, his jaw and whole body belonged to someone else at one point. And it was a similar setup to the woman. So what was going on here? Ultimately, we don't know. Did these skeletons receive an organic upgrade? Or is this some strange ritual we know little about? Tell me what you think in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't yet. Number 5. My own private Idaho snake pit. Our next scary story has a twist in the tale, or should that be T-A-I-L? This place in rural Idaho is surely Indiana Jones's worst nightmare. And it isn't some tomb or other ancient location, it's a former family home. The property turned out to be packed with snakes, hundreds of them. Not only did the house make your skin crawl, but the house itself was also crawling, what with all the creatures slipping and sliding around under the floor and in the walls. How come an innocent family wound up living in this slippery hellhole? Reports say their estate agent told them the stories they were hearing about snakes were made up. Once they moved in, they realized this was far from the case. Thankfully, the snakes in question were garter snakes, which are largely venom-free. That said, they still bite and threaten the family. At one stage, dozens had to be killed every day. Why were all the snakes in the house in the first place? Unfortunately, the property was built over what's called a hibernaculum. This is a natural hub where snakes go to hibernate during the colder months. The snakes were there first, but what a horrible experience for everybody. As if things weren't bad enough, the family filed for bankruptcy and had to leave the house. They lasted about 3 months in the house, a short amount of time in some ways, but also a remarkably long time to put up with a crowd of live-in snakes, right? Number 4. Man inside tree. When you've been brutally stabbed to death, the last thing you expect is for your body to be attacked by a tree. Yet that's exactly what happened in County Sligo, Northwest Ireland. We should point out that the two incidents happened several hundred years apart. The skeleton, which belonged to a young man of around 20 years of age, dated back to medieval times over 900 years ago. The tree, a beech, was a mere 200 years old. What happened was the tree got planted where the young man was buried, and over time, the roots took hold of his bones. Flash forward to 2015 when a big storm battered the location, tearing the tree out of the earth. The roots then yanked the top part of the skeleton from the bottom half, resulting in a scary but fascinating archaeological find. Believed to have had a Christian burial, it isn't known why the man suffered such a violent end. It certainly wasn't uncommon back then. Experts sometimes spend ages raking over the soil for signs of historical evidence. This time, Mother Nature lent a helping hand. Or to be more accurate, branch. Number 3. Mesoamerican Sacrifice Pit. Is this the site where unfortunate human beings were fed to big cats in ancient Mesoamerica? Possibly, though the jury's still out. Hundreds of years ago, Teotihuacan was a major and highly populated destination close to today's Mexico City. Temples were constructed, the remains of which are explored by archaeologists in the 21st century. And what the Mesoamerican culture left behind is incredible. Oh, and somewhat scary. Chambers contain remnants of the animal kingdom's mightiest predators. Pumas and eagles are amongst the finds, and also they appear to have been locked up there. Analysis of the remains shows their bones came under the stresses we associate with captive creatures. Before this, archaeologists identified the zoo at Tenochtitlan, also known as the Aztecs' capital city, as the oldest society keeping carnivores. The unusual presence of what could be corn in their diet shows humans fed the animals. And speaking of which, did they chow down on any human hands and other body parts? It's easy to look at this place and compare it to other ancient civilizations, where people were sacrificed or slaughtered for entertainment. The overall picture simply isn't clear enough, though sources point out old drawings which show animals eating human organs. Number 2. The scary truth about pineapples. It's pretty strange how acid plays such a big role in our day-to-day life. Hold up, acid? What do we mean? Not only do our stomachs contain acid that's strong enough to rival a car battery, but we also consume acidic foods such as fruit. Pineapples are so acidic that it's actually kind of scary. Did you know that when you put a slice of pineapple in your mouth, you're causing distress to your flesh? Zesty and zingy it might be, but the fruit also stings and burns our tongues. This is because of a natural ingredient, or rather an enzyme of the pineapple, called bromelain. Its role is to break down proteins in much the same way as our digestive system does. So what's it doing eating us as we eat it? You can see it that way. Thankfully, as scientists have shown, our mouths recover quickly enough from a pineapple hit. Ultimately, the fruity treat is just too dang tasty to ignore, acid or no acid. Number 1. Hyksos Hand Pit. So, we told you a little earlier about a scary archaeological discovery with lots of animal bones and a temple. We're about to go one scarier by mentioning an ancient discovery of hands at a site in Egypt. What is it about severed hands that's so freaky? We just can't put our finger on it. Well, these unfortunate people couldn't at any rate. What did the king want with lopped off hands anyway? The Hyksos ruled over areas of the country during a period referred to as the 15th dynasty. Experts were aware of enemies having their hands removed back then, but they had found no physical signs of this until this discovery, which happened in 2012. The former Hyksos capital of Avaris was the location where archaeologists found the 16 amputated parts. They noticed 4 pits inside a palace. Each pit contained human hands, though they were distributed strangely. 2 of the hands had a pit all to themselves, while the others got divided between the other 2 pits. Sounds weird, though the pits with a single hand are close to where the king sat, so maybe that makes sense. Could these have been more notable amputees? By taking someone's hand, specifically their right hand, you would deprive them of strength. That, and it's easier to count severed hands than it is whole corpses. The hands then apparently got swapped for gold. You could give your ruler the finger, and he wouldn't just welcome it, he'd reward you with something valuable. Maybe the king kept the hands around like ornaments, we guess. Not our idea of interior design, but hey, it worked for them. Which of these scary discoveries would you like to see personally? Let us know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe and how about a thumbs up so I know you want to see more amazing videos like this right here on American Eye.